गुड डे स्टूडेंट्स, बीए पार्ट टू स्टूडेंट्स, बीए पार्ट सेकंड स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर रीडिंग टीयर्स आइडियल टीयर्स बाय अल्फ्रेड टेनिसन। सो वी आर रिवाइजिंग दिस पोएम एंड आई एम रिवाइजिंग द समरी फॉर यू। द स्पीकर सिंग्स ऑफ द पेसलेस एंड इनएक्सप्लिकेबल टीयर्स दैट राइज in his heart and pour forth from his eyes when he looks out on the fields in autumn and thinks of the past, quote, the days that are no more, unquote. This is important. The past, the days that are no more, is described as fresh and strange. It is as fresh as the first beam of sunlight that sparkles on the sail of a boat bringing the dead back from the underworld, and it is said as the last red beam of sunlight that shines on a boat that carries the dead down to the underworld. The speaker then refers to the past as not, quote unquote, fresh, but, quote unquote, sad and strange. I'm repeating the line. The speaker then refers to the past as not fresh, but sad and strange. As such, it resembles the song of the birds on early summer morning as it rounds to a dead person who lies watching the glimmering square of the sunlight as it appears through a square narrow. In the final stanza, the speaker declares the past to be dear, sweet, deep and wild. It is as clear I'm repeating. The speaker then refers to the past as not fresh, but sad and strange. As such, it resembles the song of the birds on early summer morning as it sounds to a dead person who lies watching the glimmering square of sunlight as it appears through a square window. In the final stanza, the speaker declares the past to be dear, sweet, deep and wild. This is important. In the final stanza, the speaker declares the past to be dear, sweet, deep and wild. It is as dear as the memory of the kisses of one who is now dead, and it is as sweet as those kisses that we imagine ourselves bestowing on lovers who actually have loyalties to others. So, too, is the past as deep as first love and as wild as the regret that usually follows this experience. Quote, the speaker concludes that the past is a death in life, unquote. I'm repeating. The speaker concludes that the past is a, quote unquote, death in life. This is important. Death in life. The poem is written in blank verse or unrhymed iambic pentameter. It consists of 4-5 line stanzas, each of which closes with the word, quote, the days that are no more, unquote. So, I am repeating, the poem is written in blank verse. So, you have to remember, the poem is written in blank verse or unrhymed iambic pentameter. It consists of 4-5 lines, each of which closes with the sounds, the days that are no more, unquote. So, quote, the days that are no more, unquote. So, tears, idle tears, is part of a larger poem called, quote, unquote, The Princess. You have to remember the name, The Princess. This name may be important for short answer type questions. So, I am repeating, tears, idle tears, is part of a larger poem called The Princess, published in 1847. Tennyson wrote The Princess to discuss the relationship between the sexes and to provide an argument for women's rights in higher education. However, the work as a whole does not present a single argument or tell a coherent story. Rather, like so much of Tennyson's poetry, it evokes complex emotions and moods. Though a mastery of language, quote, tears, idle tears, unquote, a particularly evocative section is one of several interludes of song in the midst of the poem. Thank you, students. Write the summary of tears, idle tears in your own words.